Assalamu alaikum and good evening. You are watching Hamsab TV and I am Muneeb Hamid with the news. Operation underway to break up sit-in at Islamabad's Faizabad interchange. 150 arrested. Islamabad police, with the help of frontier constabulary personnel and other law enforcement agencies, have launched a crackdown against protesters camped out at the Faizabad interchange since November 8. The crackdown was launched after the last of a long series of deadlines lapsed on Saturday morning without response from the agitating parties. Roughly 8,500 elite police and paramilitary troops in riot gear are taking part in the clearance operation, which was launched soon after the final deadline of 7 a.m. given to the protesters expired. Law enforcement personnel have encircled the area and are using tear gas and rubber bullets to disperse the agitators. In response, the protesters have been using stones and rocks to attack the advancing security forces. As of 11 a.m., nearly all protesters camped out on the IJ Principal Road near the Faizabad interchange have been dispersed. However, sporadic shelling is ongoing against protesters on Rawalpindi's Murray Road. Islamabad High Court declares Faizabad sit-in a terrorist act. The Islamabad High Court on Friday declared the ongoing sit-in at Faizabad interchange as anti-state activity and an act of terrorism. Another show cause notice was issued to the Interior Minister for not implementing the court's order to clear Faizabad, observing that Ahsan Iqbal had stopped the Islamabad administration from acting upon the order passed by this court. IHC Justice Shaukat Aziz Siddiqui further asked why contempt of court proceedings may not be initiated against him. He is directed to appear in person on the next date. In his order, Justice Siddiqui noted that calling the honorable judges of superior judiciary and other respectable persons with names is intolerable, adding that the leadership of Dharna, prime facie, are involved in an act of terrorism. He also ordered that the persons identified in the report of Raja Zafrul Haq-led committee should not be allowed to leave the country. PM Army Chief to visit Saudi Arabia next week. Prime Minister Shahid Khaqan Abbasi will visit Saudi Arabia next week for a bilateral meeting with the kingdom's leadership. Though the date of the Premier's visit has not been announced yet, he is expected to travel to Saudi Arabia on November 27. He will be accompanied by Foreign Minister Khawaja Asif, Army Chief General Qamar Bajwa and ISI Chief Lieutenant General Naveed Mukhtar. The visit will be a day after the inauguration of Islamic Military Counter-Terrorism Coalition, a 41-nation coalition against terrorism in Riyadh on November 26. Crown Prince Mohammed bin Salman will open a meeting of the ministers of the Defence Council to mark the beginning of the activities. New Supreme Court bench appointed to hear Hudaybiyah Papers Mills case on November 28. The Supreme Court on Saturday ordered the constitution of a three-member special bench to hear a petition pertaining to the Hudaybiyah Paper Mills case on November 28. In an appeal, the National Accountability Bureau, NAB, has asked the Apex Court, in the interest of justice, fair play and equity, to set aside a 2014 judgment from the Lahore High Court to shut the case. Justice Mushir Alam will head the bench that will review the case's merit. He will be joined by Justice Qazi Faiz Isa and Justice Mazhar Alam Mia Khail. The new bench had to be reconstituted after Justice Asif Saeed Khosa recused himself from hearing the case. Four people killed, 19 injured in explosion on Quetta's Sarriab Road. At least four people were killed and 19 injured in an explosion in Quetta, Civil Hospital spokesperson Vaseem Beg said. A security forces vehicle at Sarriab Road was the target of the attack. Security sources claimed security and rescue officials have reached the area. The injured have been shifted to Civil Hospital Quetta, while those critically injured have been moved to trauma center. The cause of the explosion could not be immediately ascertained. At least 235 killed in attack on Egypt mosque during Friday prayers. Armed attackers on Friday killed at least 235 worshippers in a bomb and gun assault on a packed mosque in Egypt's restive North Sinai province, state media reported. The country's deadliest attack in the recent memory. A bomb explosion ripped through the Rawda mosque frequented by Sufis roughly 40 kilometers west of the North Sinai capital of El Arish before gunmen opened fire on those gathered for weekly Friday prayers, officials said. Witnesses said the assailants had surrounded the mosque with all-terrain vehicles and then planted a bomb outside. U.S. urges Pakistan to re-arrest Hafiz Saeed. The United States urged Pakistan on Friday to re-arrest Lashkar-e-Taiba leader Hafiz Saeed and charge him with the crimes he is accused of committing. Mr. Saeed, who has been designated a terrorist by the U.S. Justice Department, was released early on Friday after a court on Wednesday rejected the government's plea for a 60-day extension in his house arrest. The Pakistani government should make sure that he is arrested and charged for his crimes, said the State Department in a statement issued hours after Mr. Saeed's release. China to get 91 PC Gwadar income, minister tells Senate. The Senate was told on Friday that 91% of the revenues to be generated from the Gwadar port as part of the China-Pakistan economic corridor would go to China, while the Gwadar Port Authority would get 9% share in the income for the next 40 years. This was disclosed by Federal Minister for Ports and Shipping Mir Hasil Bizenjo after senators expressed concern over the secrecy surrounding the CPEC long-term agreement plan, with many observing that the agreement titled heavily in China's favor. The minister said that the agreement was based on a built, operate and transfer model spread over 40 years. That means that Pakistan will take over the operation of the port along with the infrastructure to be built on it during the period to enhance the port's cargo handling capacity. Weather forecast for next 12 hours. Mainly cold and dry weather is expected in most parts of the country. However, light rain with light snowfall over the hills is expected at few places in Malakand Division and Gilgit-Baltistan. And that is the end of the news. For more news and updates, keep watching Hamsab TV. Take care.